Well, bonjour to vous. That's the sort of sophisticated patter you'll get from a woman who's still got a boyfriend. Though elegance in the world of romance eludes me.
Oh, wow, look, a robin.
Lovely. But I'm proving myself a good lady woman for Mike. Well, I don't want to lose him, he's great. But Operation Maintain Dignity means a suppressed silliness bursts out at inappropriate moments.
No. Close your eyes. Breathe. In and out. Relaxed. Peaceful and calm.
But generally, I'm sophisticated girlfriend personified. I know this because A, I now own a pashmina. And B, I've stopped giggling when people say sausage.
Can you sign these? Oh, look at this place. Just one night without Mike and the real you explodes.
Well, I'm not ready for him to know that I make fruit friends and new vegetables. Meet Mr. Butternut.
Hello to you.
I don't want that to put him off.
And what are you wearing?
I happen to be sporting an elasticated culotte.
Because you're a PE teacher from 1987?
I've got nothing else left to wear. Washing machine's broken. Do you want a round of swing muffin?
Of course.
Good luck.
Oh!
Oh, it's Mike! Oh! Can you pop set?
Mock not!
Fruit friends! I taxed the same house and I just
stopped. Oh, I've missed you.
I've missed you too. I just came to get a glimpse, really.
Oh, calm down. Pass my pashmina.
No.
It's my chic look.
What's that?
That is Stevie's?
Yeah, it's mine. Well, it's my friend's. I'm looking after it while she's away. She didn't want to leave him in a kennel.
Just play a game.
I'm walking.
Oh, come on, we could play What Cereal Am I? Or Can We Fit Stevie in a Pillowcase? Sorry.
Oh!
My pants have gone northwards. Oh, specifically north-northeast. Sorry.
Oh, this is a public space!
Oh, but I washed these last pair of pants in the dishwasher and it sort of melted them. Resourceful. Oh dear, no. It's getting really uncomfortable now, actually. I'm going to have to take my pants off. Sorry, sir, I didn't see you and immediately think I must take my pants off. I'm not being lewd. Do excuse me. Oh, no, I'm not sure about this going commando business.
I'm so sorry.
I'm a culotte incident away from moonery, careful.
How you think you're fit for the adult world of relationships is beyond me.
For that statement, I find myself begging your pardon.
You're pretending to be someone you're not when you're with Mike. In one night without him, you're a child again, and the notion of not wearing pants is hilarious. Just popping your maturity on the end of my flagpole.
You're just jealous, Miss Singletoo Pops. I'm a functioning adult in a mature relationship.
Darling, I got your bed sheets. I ironed the Knight Rider duvet because David Hasselhoff was looking peculiar.
Penny does is sort out your life.
Excuse me, little Miss Oompa Loompa. I have a very busy life. I'm having work done on my kitchen. There are lunches, rotors. This week I'm on the rota-rota of a rotary. I only did these because Miranda has to find a new plumber.
It's just down here, Governor, my friend, all right? Little green, just in.
Okay, look, let's just quickly seal this crack, shall we?
Great, I'm to have a mature adult day about town, fully commando. Actually, I'm beginning to enjoy the freedom now.
Oh, it's fabulous. I've been pantless since...
Don't say that.
I skinny dipped with Christopher Plummered me thrice. Such fun!
I'll never recover. Oh, that's breezy. How do you negotiate the frozen food aisles? Serious woman. I'm not wearing any pants. Enjoy your meatballs. Hi, Gary. Hi, Ruth.
Hey.
Where did you put the muslins, Papa Bear?
What's going on?
Well, I was meant to be babysitting for Chris and Alison, but I've got this urgent loan application I've got to fill out.
Tell her.
He's buying the restaurant.
Wow, that's so exciting, Gary.
Thank you.
Congrats, babe.
Thanks, buddy.
See you later.
Yeah. You sure you can't help us, Gary?
Well, hello, babysitter.
Well, hello, responsibility.
Hello, rude.
We're having a little bosom leakage.
Oh, still breastfeeding.
Well, nothing beats mother's that, eh? So, good news. Miranda's off to babysit.
Oh, well, good Astrid. It's only a couple of hours. It's a hospital appointment.
She's got to have a scrape.
Oh, right, okay. Now that's the kind of word you should mouth, all right?
You want to
might another. Try for another. Only I can speak for my vagina.
Why? Why, Delilah?
Going to have fun with Auntie Miranda. We booked a music session at the Soft Play Centre. So, nappies, wipes, spare wipes out, Mr. Poo Poo.
Now, come on, dumpling. Thank you. Your life saver.
Oh, nearly snogged there. Right, okay. Sophisticated lady are coming through.
Madam.
Get a fun, aren't we, little.
It's nearly time to finish up, so on to the final round. She sings every string, it's truly brilliant. And from that sound we had a...
My turn. Dolphin out of that. With a... There, here, there, everywhere.
Right, I think we'll end it there.
Move on.
Oh, all right, okay.
Kids backing up.
Oh, stink. Someone looks a bit stuck. This is the only way down.
In my back, I can't. I'm scared.
Yes, I think we ought to be able to ease that.
So, if you'd like to get down to your bra and vest and pants, then I'll pop back in a moment. Yes, 20 milligrams of Voltarol should do that. And tell her that I'll speak to her when I've seen my patient.
Oh, my. You do need the paper on the couch. I presumed it was there for origami. Hence the origami pants slash napping. Has anyone ever done you a swan or...
No, you're the first patient who's done origami.
Well, it's a happy day for us both then, isn't it?
So if you'd like to lie face up on the couch, please.
As the osteo said to the patient. No? Oh, hello. Intimate, isn't it? We'll have to become engaged after this, sir. Wig! Wig!
And perhaps you'd like to lie on your side, please.
Okay. Oh! Did we just consummate our engagement?
So, just one final stretch, okay?
Oh, good day to you. One, why are you wearing your Where's Miranda outfit? And B, how is your mature day about town?
One, I've only got this left wear, washing machine's still broken. And B, I got stuck in a tunnel in a soft play centre, did my back in, went pantless to an osteopath where I farted and blew out a candle.
I know.
And instead of getting over it like a normal 30-something with a glass of wine and a leaf-through Tatler, last night I got a felt-tip pen and decorated my breasts as Jedward. Mike is going to realise I'm a nonsense and dump me.
Then, sire, I throw down that it's time to grow up and do without mummy gauntlet.
Well, sire, I pick up your gauntlet. With such verve and vigour, I smash it about your tiny little face.
Hey, Quirky. Listen, about tonight, I just had a call from Dad. He's really down, so I said I'd go out with him tonight.
No worries.
Well, actually, he asked about finally meeting me.
Oh, that's a step. I'm not sure.
Gauntlet!
Gauntlet! Sorry. Yes, good. No, I would like to meet my boyfriend's father. Bring him round, I'll cook.
Great. Bit nervous. His previous girlfriend has always been a bit of a culling.
Culling?
Yes, he's particular.
Is he?
I've stitched your bra.
Blah, 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 blah. That's how excited I am about tonight.
Yeah. See you later.
Sorry, Mother. Sorry. It's just I am with Gauntlet, and from now on, I take all adult tasks on. For tonight, I cook for my boyfriend's father.
Sire. It's for Mike's father? No, that's fine, that's fine. Very happy not to get involved, sire. But I'm around to live well. Wine glasses, not tumblers, and use the crockery your aunt left you.
Penny, go!
Which one's that?
The flowery one.
No, which one's crockery, plates or spoons?
Help us all. Bye, darling.
Bye, Mummy.
Oh, it's for your own goods.
Red wine, meat, white wine, fish, and if in doubt, deal.
Oi! I knew you'd might never do it. Mature relationship.
Oh, well, now I have had enough of this doubting, little Miss and Mrs. Doubtfire. Yeah. And tonight I shall have a couple's dinner party. And without your help, I shall have a soiree with home-cooked fare and good crockery, which is plates. And there shall be Buble on the stereo, and I won't even laugh at the name Buble. It's got boob in it. Stevie, if you manage to get a boyfriend by tonight, do come. Right ingredients, hello to you. Alfalfa, I thought you were a llama, but a hearty welcome. Right, let's do this. Can't be that hard. It's really hard. At one point, I was told to skiffle carrots. Skiffle? Am I to play them a percussive instrument and dance with them? No carrots. I confused tisper with tisperber. Trying to do a salmon tureen starter. Who can strike clean? A piece of cling film. I was going to do crepes as that for pudding, but penis pasta, what's that doing there? That's not fun to eat in your 30s. I see only one option. All hail, Tureen. Even potatoes. Why do we bother cooking? Why?
I'm doing this fish pie for six and they'll never know. Raise the nest, putting food on our table. This cooking drives us crazy. We're busy, slash, lazy. All the morning foods are available.
Lovely. Thank you. Now go, ladies, go. Decant on your own dishes and lie. Who has caused me a wonky throw?
Now, are you sure you don't mind us babysitting? I'm really sorry. I just had to make up for Kristen Allison.
Oof. Can I put the baby monitor here?
I'm not interfering. If I were, I'd say, dab that stain off your dress.
I'm saying nothing. Mother, this is soap because I hand-washed it and I've called the plumber back. I am an in-control adult with my cocktail sausages.
This is my boyfriend. We've come for the dinner party.
You have clearly just dragged a traffic warden off the street.
No, no, we're seeing each other. Get off me. Babe, come and help me settle him.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Get this out.
Yeah, she bought the shop about 4 years ago.
Bummery, that hair. Okay, that's normal, that's normal.
Miranda, this is my father. Well, very nice to meet you, Miranda.
Very nice to meet you too, Mr. Jackford.
Call me Valerie.
Yeah, good one. Call me Derek.
Dad's name is Valerie.
What's your mum called, Dave? Right, let me introduce you to my mother. For tonight, you are a Valerie Singleton.
Dad, this is Penny.
Stevie Osteopath, he was the osteopath.
Oh.
Sir, could I take your coat? So, lovely, and your keys?
Or shall I throw them in a bowl?
It's a joke. It's a joke.
Sorry, are you okay?
Yes, of course, yes. Now, do sit down. Let me plump you a scatter cushion. Help yourself to sausages. Can I get get you a warming glass o' roux. I'm so getting cold. Wig, wig, wig. There you go.
Oh, thank you.
Now do relax in my nibble and mingle zone. So what do you do?
He's just done an explosive poo right up to his armpits. Well, on that note, I think I'll leave.
It's a joke. Yeah, it was a joke.
I shat myself once.
Now, let me just sort out my dessert. I've got syphilis. Physalis! Physalis! The fruit's exotic fruit. I have not got syphilis. Laughter delay. Now, you know what's for dessert, but for starter, we're having a smoked salmon tureen, and for main, we shall be having lamb. So, the tureens, I'll just get them out. And the tureens. It's a joke about getting your breasts out instead of the tureens. One for you. Nothing.
Oh, thank you. Shall we say grace?
Oh, yeah. Oh, right, yes, of course. No, I always do. Me? Right. Lord, we thank you for the music. The songs we're singing. We thank you for your bread of heaven. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Feed me till I want no more so much. Thank you very much. To you, God, please. Amen.
Now, what did you use?
Oh, well, skills, utensils, tureen mix, tureen powder.
I think I've got a bit of pants in my tureen.
They'll be Miranda's. You had to wash them in the dishwasher.
Do you excuse me while I just check on my gravy?
I'll go.
So are you thinking of having children, Miranda? All that dribbling and talking gibberish, you've got plenty in common.
Do you think you could do the laugh while you're making the joke? That way there won't be any false starts.
I think she'd make a great mum.
Well, she's already got a very weak pelvic floor. Such fun!
Penny, why don't you tell us about the work you're having done?
Yes, what are you having done? The crow's feet, I can see. What
on my kitchen. On my kitchen, you stupid old...
Shall we play a game, shall we? Heads, shoulders, knees and toes.
It's a kid's game.
Yes, it's a ridiculous suggestion. I prefer dinner party convo. So, well, Norman, what do you do for a hobby?
I like to let kittens feed from my beard. What about the were game? You know, if you could be a were animal for one night, like a werewolf, what animal would you be?
What? Like Valerie would be a were toupee.
My landlord it's okay. I've made a new gravy. I'm clawing it back. Oh, my meat's gone over. Oh, five second rule.
What is going on?
My meat's gone over. Valerie thinks I'm insane. You're not helping.
Now, listen here. I like Mike, and you are more than good enough for him. I do not like Valerie. I will not be dictated to by Stevie, the crazed leprechaun, and a man with a dead badger on his head. We stick together.
Oh, Mummy, help me with a new main course. Mum, the microwave's about to go ping. I'll put the M&S potatoes in there.
What are you two up to in there?
Nothing! So, we thought we saw a mouse. Mouse?
What? Really, Bay? Oh, you need to man up. I am so pleased my daughter's moved on to your lovely son, Vanessa.
What do you mean, moved on?
She's had a thing for Gary for years.
It wasn't really a thing.
Well, was it a thing or wasn't it a thing?
Well, if you can call a couple of dates.
You dated?
Well, nothing ever really happened.
Oh, tell me about it. On off.
And do you still want it to be on?
No.
I'll give you a hand.
You are not doing Miranda any favours. She's on a losing streak with that Valerie. Her first proper boyfriend, and the father's got the personality of a self-service checker. Oh, that wig. It's like roadkill. Yeah, well, if Miranda gets desperate, we can always grill that.
This monitor's on, isn't it?
Brazen wee.
Sir, can I get you a drink? Would you like a tea, perhaps a chamomile?
She's got a red bush.
The tea! Sorry, I was making the creeps of that.
Son, I've had enough of this. I don't care to come to a so-called dinner party to be insulted by your girlfriend's freaky friends and dysfunctional family.
Excuse me, my functional is not dysfamily. We are not dysfunctional.
Mr. Chatford, I know I haven't portrayed myself well, but I am a capable woman.
Then why is foam rising throughout your kitchen?
I put fiery liquid in the dishwasher. I am normal.
Hello? I'm only coming in if you don't wax my crack again, all right?
Is that penis, Pastor?
Right. That's it. I drop the gauntlet. For the last 2 days, I've tried to be a grown-up, but I have no interest in abiding by the adult rule book. I want to do fun things that make me happy, which, by the way, for the record, include making vegetables. Meat. Mr. Butternut. You might call me a child good, for if adults had even the slightest in-the-moment joy of a child, then frankly, the world would be a better place. Oh, and the tureen, M&S.
Well, I bet you're glad your thing with her's over now.
No. Miranda's my best friend, Rose, and I'm not going to say what you want me to say. So if you can't handle that, then do you know what? It's over.
Fine.
Come on, Mike. No, I'm staying.
These last 2 days, I've been worried that you weren't who I thought you were because I was falling in love with you. Your ridiculous sense of humour and your smile and the way that you bring me out of my boring shell and... Well, hearing what you just said, I realise I have fallen in love with you. I love you, Quirky. Do you know what I really want to do?
Fire fight!
To the river that is running to the promised land.